Hey guys, welcome back. So today I'm doing a video on public demand. Well, I can say public demand because a couple of people did request me to make this. So thank you to those couple of people. So today we are going to do my cool and calm reaction to the Man Booker Prize shortlist. So I'm shooting this on 16th of September and I'm hoping that I upload it on 17th or 18th of September. I don't know, I cannot see the future, but this is my cool and calm reaction because the list came out yesterday at 5:30 PM IST, and since then I have been on this discussion with a lot of people, Instagram, the Discord for the Booker Boy Booker Club, the internet in general, because I've been watching so many YouTube videos about the shortlist reactions and people have been reacting live as well. But I didn't do that, I didn't think I had to do that, but since like the whole of my Instagram has been taken by storm because of all these posts that I put and people replying me continuously, I finally decided that I have to film a calm reaction video. Like, I didn't want to do like an on the spot one because I think the shortlist is a bit disappointing. And if I would have done like a reaction at that point of time, I would go on a full blown rant and I didn't want to do that. And that's why I thought about it. I have collected my thoughts. All my thoughts are in my brain. And finally, we discuss. So, let me just start the video. Oh, oops, my tripod just shook, but ignore it. So, let's just start the video with all the predictions that I had made on my Instagram one day before the shortlist. So I posted it on my Instagram stories and this is the image that's there. So basically my options for, or my predictions, why am I saying options, damn. Okay, my predictions were, spectacles because paper, that's like a rule. My first option, of course, Burnt Sugar, Who They Was, The Mirror and the Light, because we cannot skip Mantel, Shaggy Bane, How Much of These Hills Is Gold, and A Pyro Gone. So these were my predictions, shortlist predictions, which were posted on Instagram, and basically I am just shook because of a lot of things. And I was shook, but now I'm not. Now I'm finally here. Like, I know certain explanations and I know certain things now. Like, I'm more informed, I feel. And now I can finally, like, give you my opinion on the shortlist since I'm, like, cool and calm right now. So let's see what actually got shortlisted. The New Wilderness, This Mournable Body, Burnt Sugar, The Shadow King, Real Life, and Shaggy Bane. So these were the ones that got shortlisted. So if you see, I kind of only guessed two of them correctly. That's Burnt Sugar and Shaggy Bane. I mean, I think these were like the Booker favorites, even for the internet. And although I have not read Shaggy Bane or Burnt Sugar yet, I've started with Burnt Sugar. Yay. But I knew that, these two have like, people have raved about the book. So I knew this was going to be there. So that's fine. Let's talk about the other books that are on the shortlist. So the first one is The New Wilderness. I am actually surprised because I'm yet to read this, and I was planning not to read this after all because I never knew that this would be a part of the shortlist. It's surprising, it's shocking, I think. But then I have to like check it out because if this book is anything like the Over Story, then I know I'm not going to like it. Like, the Over Story by Richard Powers was not my type. But if The New Wilderness is a book that I should read because it's in the shortlist, I will read it. I will give this book a chance. Yeah, so another surprise is This Mournable Body. Now, I am a bit surprised because I did read this book. I gave it 4.5 stars. But for real, I didn't find it Booker material because, I don't know, I mean, having read like some Booker Prize winners before, I know that this is one of those books that don't have that Booker element in them, except for like one Booker element, they don't have the others in them. Like, I don't know, Booker books are like always a bit unique, I would say, like in some or the other element. And they tend to be like books that either people love a lot or either people hate. Like, there are very few Booker books where, you know, people have been on the same page and been like, oh, you know what, I love that book. So it's always been like that. I mean, I think Girl, Woman, Other is one of those, you know, where people like, everyone likes it in general. So yeah, so I'm very surprised, right? Because, okay, so I've not read Nervous Conditions or the Book of Nod, and I read Dismoanable Body as a standalone. So like stated in my previous videos, like weekly reads, where I had stated that you should read this book after reading the first two books, but this can be read as a standalone. So I'm very surprised because this book alone does not like make a book, okay? You have to read, I think, the whole series. If you read it and then you think about it, then maybe it can be a book or trilogy or a book or, I don't know. Excuse me. Oh, so you get my point. Anyway, so I'm surprised. Talking about The Shadow King. So The Shadow King is one book that I thought I would not read because I have heard a lot of negative reviews about it, because there's a lot of exaggerated history, and I am just, I would say, surprised that The Shadow King is out there. But you know what, again, since it's on the shortlist, I'm giving the book a chance. I am overlooking that one factor of exaggerated history, and then I'm going to read it, so don't worry about that. The next one is Real Life. So I did want to read Real Life, but the point is that Real Life was something that people really liked. And I even, this is in my TBR as well. So I'll be reading Real Life anyway, and I don't have much to say on Real Life because I've not read it yet. And yeah, that's that. Now let's talk about like the books that actually missed out, and I feel that it should have been there. And before that, I mean, I know everyone's talking about this, but let me just say, I'm actually happy that The Mirror and the Light did not get selected, although it's a good book. Apparently, and it did not get selected. I think the whole idea of the Booker this time is for diversity and stuff like that, so that's very interesting, and that's why maybe Mantle did not get selected. I won't say I'm happy or like overexcited. I'm like, yeah, I can understand that point and I support your cause, so that's good. Yeah, so let's talk about the book which I really think should have been shortlisted, and that is Who They Was by Gabriel Krauser. Honestly, I really, really, really love this book, and this is a Booker type book, okay? It's, okay, I know that this is not like a Booker winning book, but it is a book that's more of like a Booker price taste. I hope I make sense. Like, it's a very nice book, and honestly, I love the audiobook. The author is pretty cool, because when I posted this on Instagram on how this book lost the shortlist, and you know, it deserved to be on the shortlist, I got a sweet note from the author as well. So it was very sweet of Gabriel to send that across. But I really think that Who They Was did miss out. I do think that Who They Was should have been on the shortlist. As of yesterday, I was very disappointed and I was like very angry. But as of today, I'm just like, okay, you know what? We cannot change reality, and Who They Was should have been there. So that's that. Phew. Another book that I did think that did have to come on that particular shortlist was How Much of These Hills Is Gold. I have not read this book yet, and I was planning to read this book this week after the book was shortlist, because I was 100% sure that How Much of These Hills Is Gold is going to be shortlisted. But this is, again, I feel, a very Booker type book, like, you know, debut author, stuff like that, I think. So I don't know, it's a very weird list, right? It's a very weird short list. And again, my question is, like, why wasn't Who They Was selected? It's very bad. I understand why a Pyrogon was not selected, because that was there in my original shortlist predictions. Now the point is, like, Booker tends to be trashy at times, and I didn't think that they would overlook the sexual assault case against the author of Pyrogon. But yeah, I mean, you know what, good for the Booker, and I'm happy they did that. I mean, that particular thing which they did, where they overlooked a book because of some allegations against the author, I think it's a good message, and they did not want to get embroiled in that particular controversy, so good for them. So yeah, I think that's it. That's like my Booker reaction, my cool and calm Booker shortlist reaction. Honestly, I didn't think I would ever like shoot this for YouTube. I was planning to do like a winner prediction video, but not this one. But here we are. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time. Bye.